It's a great start. I feel like we're doing great already. Don't you feel like we're doing great already?
I feel like we're doing amazing.
We're doing great already. Okay, so, like most nights, no, this isn't the resolution I wanted. Gosh darn it. That's what I want.
Why that resolution?
No, that's not what I wanted either. Yeah, that other one actually looked too good.
Go through them. Wait, that's not a bad one. Keep going. That's what you want.
That's what, okay. There we go. That looks all right. Now, okay, so we didn't have a plan. Like, we usually don't have a plan.
Yeah, yeah.
It, you know, it's fair to say that we usually don't have a plan. Here we go. And but there was that Humble Bundle that I want to say so far has raised something crazy like $6 million.
What are they raising it for?
There's
what is Humble Bundle for people who don't know?
Everyone knows.
We shouldn't. Don't assume things. Don't assume shit.
For people who watch this 10 years from now going, what was Grandpa talking about? Humble Bundle is a website that often has game sales. Most notably, you are able to choose the amount that you pay for the bundle. So let's say there's 5 games in the bundle.
Yeah.
You can pay whatever you want, but if you pay a certain amount, you get more things. So there was a Humble Bundle recently called the Freedom Bundle.
So they pocket all of the money?
Humble takes all the money and fuck everyone else. So there was a bundle recently. I was just getting to that, Rich. Thank you.
Setting up properly.
So a lot of the times bundles will be charitable donations.
Yeah.
And so, for example, this Freedom Bundle, there are 3 different charities that you can choose which one you wanted to donate to. ACLU, I think Doctors Without Borders was one of them, and another one that I didn't really know. And if you paid a certain amount of money for each tier, you got certain games, and you can, there's little sliders. It's actually really cool. So like, let's say, you know, fuck Doctors Without Borders. I hate those guys, but I like this other charity. You can give all the money to the other charity.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or vice versa. And so I donated to this. A bunch of people have donated to this, Freedom Bundle, and I have a shit ton of games now.
Okay.
And a lot of them were doubles. And so we will be sporadically giving out games throughout Doctors Without Degrees. I don't know what it is, but it's good charities. And we have a bunch of doubles, and so we're going to be giving away some games. Actually, could I have the laptop for a second?
Yeah.
Just so Rich can see, because at any time, if you want to give away a game, you can do that. Oh, great. Yeah, here it is. I have it up still. So here's a bunch of games. Great. And so we thought we would play some of the games that I got in the bundle that I'm not giving away, like Tower of Guns, which I've never played, but I remember has always been a game that I wanted to play. So we're gonna.
I know this is your list of games. Why am I looking at this right now?
Oh, just to let you know it's there. In case in case you want to give away a game.
Okay. Everything else out here is on the chopping block.
Well, just point it out to me before you give it away.
All right.
Point it out to me. Okay, great. Choose your perk. All right. Well, you know what? I don't know how this game works yet, so we're just gonna go. We're just gonna go, man.
Gobblegook says, "Hey guys,
hi Gobblegooks.
New York Toy Fair is this weekend,
ooh,
and they premiered a huge Transformers Triptychon set. I want. What is the most expensive toy you guys have ever spent money on for yourself? PC.
I was gonna say, like, what do you mean toy?
I've never been much of a toy collector, though I did, just because they look so nice. I went out and I got, like, the Zone of the Enders collectible action figure. Basically, it's a statue on my desk right now, but that was, I think Jehuti was, well, that was a gift. Karen got that, but I don't remember how much it was, like 50, but then I bought Anubis, which is the bad guy.
Ooh.
That was like 70. That was a splurge. But I got Anubis for a present. I had to get the opposite robot.
Yeah, yeah.
So they could be on either side of the top of my desk. But I really, really like that game.
Yeah, I'm also not a toy person. I do have that, in fact, I brought it here today. That Friday the 13th NES edition.
Oh, yeah?
It's a figure of Michael Myers, but in the NES color palette. Jason. Son of a bitch.
Jason Voorhees.
By the way, Jack is not running on all cylinders tonight. That's something you all need to know. It's just... Michael Myers, where did that even come from? Well, it's another...
Yeah.
But I should know better. It's Jason, but in the NES color palette, so he's purple and blue, and he looks hilarious. How do I change weapons? I thought I had a different weapon. Oh. Guess it doesn't really matter. So right now we're playing Tower of Guns because, you know, why not?
So what is this like one of your Humble Bundle games that you got? What is Tower of Guns? Like, how many games did you get with that bundle?
Oh, I mean, 60. An absurd amount of games. I got an amount of games that I'm just like, I will never play that many games, but... You know, you get them, and, you know, and, I got them. Some of them were ones that I wanted. Like this. This was in the bundle. I was like, oh, yeah, that's great. Guacamelee was in the bundle, and even though I have that for PS4, I don't have it for Steam. So, yeah, you know, Guacamelee. It had a bunch of stuff. And like I said, it had a bunch of doubles. And I thought to myself, oh, you know, I bet I can give that away on stream, and people would like that. People would like it if I gave those away on stream. So I was thinking of you all.
I've got to avoid looking at the screen ever since I got over the flu.
Yeah.
I'm getting motion sick really easy.
Oh, yeah, then don't look at the screen.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Rich. I did not know. I did not know that you were...
I saw some footage of, like, the newer version of Brutal Doom they're working on.
Oh, yeah.
On the YouTubes the other day, and I almost threw up. It hit me hard and fast. Oh, God!
I'm very sorry, Rich. Oh, shit. Here we go. Hello.
Are we excited for the new Zelda?
Yes!
I'm hopeful. Like, they've touted the non-linearity of it.
Yeah.
Which I find exciting.
Uh-huh.
I worry, having looked at people playing the game, that it's going to be, you know, this huge area with very little in it. I worry it's going to be a large, empty world.
You know, I keep thinking of, what was that game called? Last Titan? I played it on stream, and it's...
Oh, Titan something...
Titan's...
Quest, Titan Souls. Okay.
Titan Souls. And technically speaking, Titan Soul was a game where you could go anywhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it only had the boss battles.
Yeah.
And actually, that was one of my biggest complaints about it, is just getting to the next boss was incredibly boring.
Yeah.
And so, yes, if we run into a situation where it's no fun walking around... Yeah.
Rich did not love Skyward Sword. He did it on what did I call that? The other show I did, the last it got canceled.
Oh, did you do Skyward Sword on GameStation?
GameStation, and nah, I panned it.
Yeah, as you should. It's pretty bad. Pretty bad game. But Wind Waker's great. And you know what? Even just sailing around in Wind Waker was fantastic.
I think sailing in Wind Waker is a fair thing to criticize. For whatever reason, when I played it, for me, the illusion of it being a larger world because you spent a lot of time in a fucking boat worked.
That's what I'm saying. No, I loved sailing, is what I'm saying. And sailing in Wind Waker made it okay just to fuck around in the open world. So,
this game's huge. I spend 45 minutes sailing to the next island I gotta go to. Wow. So huge. There's so much else in that game that works.
Well, yeah, there's a lot in that game that works. The combat's fucking phenomenal. The whole, like, spinning around enemies shit, I love that. Love that shit.
Yeah. Shadam Freuda says...
Shadam Freuda!
Hey, homies.
Homie!
Please say the following sentence.
Okay. Right. Is that just you Hold or
on.
Me too?
Probably just one of us. Okay. Alexa... Add watch previously recorded to my to-do list. Cheers.
Hey Siri, open up pornography in my web browser.
You're gonna start a thing. You're gonna start a thing now. We can't let this get out of hand. This could easily get out of hand.
You know, I replayed Twilight Princess recently, and I don't think it holds up as well. A lot of cutscenes.
Eh.
A lot of cutscenes.
It does Ocarina of Time better than Ocarina of Time did. Mad props to Twilight Princess.
I don't know what that... A lot of bullshit in Twilight Princess, looking back on it. A lot of bullshit. Fair amount of bullshit in Twilight Princess.
Twilight Princess is boring. Not as boring as Skyward Sword.
Oh, God. Agreed. But I think, like, I loved Twilight Princess when it came out. I remember damn near getting emotional at the ending of it. I really liked the characters, but on replay, now that I am older and theoretically wiser, a lot of it was just get through with all of this inane bullshit.
You are allergic to cutscenes.
I am deathly allergic to cutscenes.
Are they any better when they're not cutscenes and you're just standing around and it forces you to talk to somebody?
What do you mean?
I mean like, I forget it because I bitch about them way too much. So just forget about it. I'll tell you, I like The Order.
Sure. Okay.
Is it any better when it's not really a cutscene? Is that any better?
No, that's it's just any, but well, I guess here's the thing. Now, in The Order, they were mostly cutscenes. Any time in which I can do nothing, like, you know, there's plenty of times in Half-Life 2 as Gordon Freeman that you just kind of have to sit around a room and listen to people talk, right?
Mm-hmm.
But while I'm in that room, I can look around, I can touch other things, I can goof off, right?
Mm.
I have some control as a character. And that's all I'm really looking for here, is like, I just want control as a character.
No More Heroes, the cutscenes usually manage to get a freaking laugh out of me. And I don't see them working as well if it's a disguised cutscene. It's not really a cutscene, but you're just walking around.
Eh. No, you know, like what we were talking
Obviously,
about.
Obviously, if like the cutscene is 45 minutes long and boring, they're doing something wrong. But
no, you know who,
but just as a concept, I don't hate cutscenes for the sake of hating cutscenes.
You know who,
and I think that's where our opinion differs.
I don't necessarily hate them. I guess I do. You know, looking back on it, who handled it incredibly well is Arkham Knight. Remember Arkham Knight?
Yeah.
Like, never a cutscene, even though they were technically cutscenes.
Yeah, a few. Well, I don't know about Knight. I know, not off the top of my head, I can't remember, but I know. Asylum had a few,
but like, remember in Arkham Knight, like, you know, we were Batman and we were stuck in the cage, and it was basically a cutscene, but you could still move and look around, and then they turned that whole move and look around thing to the storytelling advantage.
Sure, I'm not sure how well that would work in something like No More Heroes, like Different Strokes for Different Folks. Yeah. There's no, this is the right answer, and this is the way every game needs to tell its story. Alright, what do we got here?
Oh. Like a question for you.
This time it's Lupus says, hey guys!
Hi, Lupus!
Participating in a charity event Thursday for a charity benefiting kids with cancer. I highly recommend people donate money for kids with cancer at their website. Should I say it?
For kids with cancer? Is it a real thing?
I don't know how you feel about, you know, plugging something, that's all. For all I know, I have to trust them that this is a real thing.
Sure. Go for it. Yeah.
All right. OneStepCamp.org. And if you go there and it's like a virus that destroys your computer and steals your credit card information, I'm horribly sorry because I know nothing about them.
Who do we blame?
But this time it's Lupus. They've been around for a while. I doubt they're... Okay.
What was
it's not
again?
Suspicious. OneStepCamp.org.
And kids with cancer. You can help the kids with cancer, man.
Maybe this time it's Lupus' computer got infected by some kind of Trojan hack bot that's
sure.
trying to spread itself.
Yeah.
Through donations to previously recorded.
That's a really bad
Jack,
hack bot.
Have you considered that maybe we are the cancer?
Rich, you're blowing my mind. Shit. Oh, I see what's going on. You know what? I guess I didn't, and that was my problem. That was my problem all along.
Death Metal 616! Marvel Universe reference.
What?
Is that still valid anymore?
Death Metal?
No, 616.
What is that?
At some point, they decided that the Marvel parallel universes would have numbers, and the main Marvel universe we had been following was universe number 616.
Oh, is that true?
Yes.
Oh, how funny.
But then they just did that Secret Wars, which I think they had their own Crisis on Infinite Earths bullshit, so I'm not sure that's even valid anymore. They say, just wanted to thank you guys for recommending the Stanley Parable. I bought it last week and really enjoyed it. Thought Jack might be interested to know that I'm not a hardcore gamer.
Oh. I am interested in knowing that. A lot of people after our gaming noob play Stanley Parable wanted Jay to play it. And I think he's just in the same boat as far as non-hardcore gamer playing something like the Stanley Parable, where it's like, even with Karen, it's not necessarily about like being a hardcore gamer, but it's being willing to learn. And I just don't think Jay cares enough about games to like put in the time to learn, you know?
I don't know. It's fine.
Hey, it's fine.
Rebel Bases. Hey, Rich. Thought you'd be happy to know that after years of being a console gamer, I put my big boy pants on and built my first gaming PC. Congratulations! It feels nice, doesn't it? After you built your own PC. Once you like built your computer, you feel that ownership. That is my computer. I know because I fucking built it. It's a great feeling.
I'll tell you what, Rich. It's really nice, and you hate like. Because I've been on the other foot.
Yeah.
Because like I've been on the console gamer side and like, it's all right, I understand its limitations. But now that I've finally crossed over, part of you is just like, what the hell was I thinking? You know, it's like you finally get out of the cult and you go, I was in a cult! Why didn't anyone tell me I was in a cult? Oh, everyone told me? So, you know, congratulations, building your own PC. Yeah, and then, you know what? It's just fun. That's like adult Legos right there.
Death Metal 616 in the chat saying, wish I knew how to build a PC. You know what? Just do some Googling searches. I mean, it's not as difficult as you would think it is.
I did it.
Jack did it. And
what I'm did a you, what dumbass.
What did you know about building a computer before you did it?
Oh, the most computer-intensive thing I had done before that was installing new RAM.
Yeah.
Like taking out old RAM and putting in new RAM. That was it. That was all I did.
All it takes, a little bit of reading just to educate yourself.
Yep. PCPartsPicker.com.
You'll be nervous when you do it, especially your first time.
Yeah. We've
Her camera seems to be fried.
Again. We'll have to figure out how to unfry our camera another time.
Last time it was a Windows update, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So
last time.
We'll work on that. So we'll unfry our camera another time. We just got rid of the overlay for now. And I've also disabled some of the fancier options on the old... I disabled some of the fancier options on the game just in case it was a game OBS issue.
Did the light go out on the camera when it flopped?
Yeah, the light is no longer on on the camera. Well, now we have a different kind of glitch in the game.
What's wrong?
Look, do you see that
light
part of the menu that stuck around? Hold! Wish to quit.
All right, Game Child UK says,
yep,
for the new Star Trek series, there are two types of episodes I want them to do. An episode or two-parter in the Mirror Universe. And we've gone down that well too often, haven't we? And don't we need to get to know the new crew before we can really be interested in, the evil versions of them?
Yes.
That's like season two or three.
Oh, well, that's even beyond season two or three. Like, they need to, they need to be well established.
And an episode involving Nazis. These are essential Trek requirements. In this political climate, you cannot talk about Nazis. You can't. You hear what happened to PewDiePie?
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
He lost his YouTube Red Show, didn't he?
Just the YouTube Red Show.
Oh, sure, but that's probably a lot of money for him.
Sure.
Because the Wall Street Journal decided to edit a piece of slander. They took a few Hitler jokes he made, completely out of context, slapped some ominous music over it, then they sat back and laughed while the man got hurt personally. I hope he sues their fucking asses off.
No, because, here's the thing. However, it's not like... Out of context is one thing. It's not like they fabricated him saying things. He made some tasteless jokes. We've made some tasteless jokes.
Yeah, we've made more tasteless jokes.
We've made more tasteless jokes. We don't have to deal with corporations.
No.
He does, and that's part of it.
So that absolves the Wall Street Journal for being unethical hacks?
They said, hey, PewDiePie made some Nazi jokes.
He made some Nazi jokes.
And he did.
He said they were just jokes.
They were jokes.
But listen to this ominous music. It was
what they did
was fucking awful, and they should be ashamed.
No, they said, hey, this guy who has a giant audience is making Nazi jokes, and the people...
So what?
You know what? Hey, Rich, I don't care that he made Nazi jokes. You know who does care? His corporate sponsors. Who cares? Who cares if they put ominous music or cut together a highlight clip of all of them? He has all of his subscribers who had his back. I have his back as a creator.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He can say whatever the fuck he wants to say, but you know what? Like, corporations don't need to keep paying him.
All right, we're getting into politics now, which is why you can't talk about Nazis.
We're not getting into politics.
It's going to get close to politics.
Why is this blur thing here now? What the fuck is with that?
This game sucks. That's why that blur thing's
there. Honestly, this game is poorly optimized. But no, who cares if his, he had a deal with Disney, they dropped him. He had a deal with YouTube Red, and they dropped him. Why? Because they don't like controversy. That's the price you pay dealing with corporations. What's going to happen to him is nothing. He's going to keep doing a show, he's going to keep saying dumb jokes, and that's going to be the whole thing. He's fine.
He lost a lot of money because somebody defamed him. He might have grounds for a lawsuit.
No. They cut together,
if I were the Wall Street Journal, I might actually be worried about
that. They cut together clips of him saying shit. Like, they didn't, like, Homer Simpson him. Remember the Venus de Milo episode where he grabbed the babysitter's ass? Like, they didn't fabricate him saying stuff. They just showed the stuff that he said. It's fine. It's going to be fine. And once again, chat, before you flip the fuck out, I will defend PewDiePie's artistic license to make whatever joke he wants to make.
Yeah.
He's absolutely free to make those jokes. Just like Disney is free not to have ties with him, right? So it's just totally not a big deal.
All right. Gobblegux says,
great.
Steam is Transformers games on sale today. You guys played Devastation. Do you think it's worth $10? They also have Fall of Cybertron for $10, and it looks pretty good. Not sure if you've tried that. I haven't.
Devastation is not worth $10.
$10's not much.
It's not worth it.
It depends on how much you make. How much is $10 worth to you? two things. How much is $10 worth to you?
Yeah.
And how nostalgic are you for the Transformers?
Oh, I suppose.
Those are the two questions you have to ask yourself.
Yeah.
I didn't particularly like the game. I didn't particularly enjoy it. I like Optimus Prime. His friend run around as Optimus Prime a little bit.
No, you're gonna get like maybe an hour worth of nostalgia.
Sure, it's repetitive.
It's repetitive.
Insane lack of enemy variety.
Oh my god. Yeah, no, I just can't imagine you're gonna get
combat that's kind of a letdown compared to other games Platinum has made.
I can't imagine you're gonna get $10 worth, even if you're super rich. And love the fucking Transformers.
Anonymous says, today in Target, I saw an old man in an aisle staring at the cover of the Amy Schumer book where you see her bare back. He had a boner. I thought of Rich. Well, that's nice. Anonymous says, Rich, no love for the Vic Viper? Transforms into a plane, which fills me with childlike wonder. Also, are Jehudi / Anubis sturdy? I may splurge them eventually, now that I know they exist. Thanks. I don't particularly have any love for the Vic Viper. I think it's probably the ugliest robot in Zone of the Enders. Though I guess if you're fond of Gradius, it might be neat to have.
The Zone of the Enders thing.
As far as the Zone of the Enders, Jehudi and Anubis figures, are they sturdy? Well, they got joints that click into place, so I'm not worried about, like, the pose just kind of bleh over time.
Uh-huh.
And they come with stands that hold them up, which, for Anubis, you are going to 100% need. You might have some luck getting Jehudi to stand. It's got little feet pegs.
Okay.
But I don't know why you wouldn't rather use the stands to do some kind of cool mid-air flying pose.
Well, there you go.
Movie Boozer says, this weekend I watched Things and got into a debate with a friend. I hope you can resolve.
Oh my god. Things.
Gun to your head, if you had to rewatch Things or Bloodshack, which would you do?
Bloodshack.
And why Bloodshack?
Bloodshack.
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 Bloodshack. Bloodshack is Bloodshack is fun. Things is a grueling experience.
Things is a marathon in suffering. Which is why Jay loves Things, and I have no idea why. Rich and I are not on the same page on a lot of issues.
We're on the same page with Things.
Things is awful. Bloodshack, for the ending alone, is worth it. I love
there's
it.
There's a real trooper. That was the trooper, but there's a real trooper, though.
Oh, the trooper. Ah, the trooper. Bloodshack is great. Bloodshack is where we coined our phrase "shooting the rodeo,"
which we've used twice on camera, and people are like, "So what?"
People have never questioned us when we say "shoot the rodeo," but "shoot the rodeo" refers to when you take advantage of something that just happens to be happening near your shoot to add production value.
There's a section in Bloodshack where they're It's a lot of scenes in a rodeo. Yep. A lot of B-roll from a rodeo. And obviously, when they were shooting it, there was a rodeo in town, so they took advantage of that to get some shots at the rodeo.
Yeah.
Which added to the perceived production value of Blood Shack.
Mm-hmm. I think we talked about it during that during Pocket Ninjas, where the kids were at some sort of parade.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it was obviously just one of those situations where, like, hey, there's a parade in town, quick, we'll just go shoot next to the parade, and then it'll look like we had a parade in our movie. Great. Oh, God, I need to get rid of that glare. That is really bothering the crap out of me. And I hope that's bothering the crap out of everyone else. It raises perceived production value is what it does.
Yeah.
Doesn't raise actual production value, but perceived production value. How do I get out of here? I think that's where I came in.
Bill LaHecka says, So, about how you built your own PCs. Worst timing ever.
That's very true. That's hilariously true. We were talking about how we built our own PCs and then our PC happened to crash. Listen.
You know what? It happened to crash and we were talking about it. At the end of the day, I can still use a fucking mouse to play shooters.
Yep.
And for me, that is ultimately the most important thing. That is why I am a PC gamer. That is probably like the most important reason for me.
Just to use a mouse.
Yeah. I like having control over that. I like being able, like, if I want to mod something or if I want to customize my controls, love that.
Yeah, that's nice.
You don't really get good strategy games on the console. I guess XCOM came out in the console way. XCOM 2 didn't.
Fuck, XCOM is on the iPad, motherfucker. XCOM is on the Vita, and no one has a Vita. XCOM is on everything at the moment.
I thought you didn't even like shooters, Rich. Well, you've seen me gush over Doom and Vanquish.
Where do you get the idea that Rich doesn't like shooters?
I don't like shooters with a gamepad.
Yeah, okay.
Might be what you're thinking of. Aiming with a gamepad, for me personally... You people there you out go. There who enjoy
you
it.
To, you have to add that.
Is just the worst fucking thing. It's the most uncomfortable thing. I will PC game just because of the mouse.
Yeah, and you know, as a convert, as someone who used to defend aiming with a controller, and I will always defend the comfort of a controller.
Mm-hmm.
To me, a controller is infinitely more comfortable than using a keypad or a number pad or anything. That's why I use this little thing. But there's never an argument about what's more accurate or what you can do more with. Ready? Are you ready for something?
Yeah.
Tower guns. I gotta go this way, right?
Yeah.
But what if there's an enemy, like, to my right? Oh, no, there's not. No, there's not. No, there's not. Can you do that with a fucking gamepad?
We'll imitate it.
Okay, so like, oop, there's it. Like, oh, I'm over here, I'm shooting. Is there an enemy? No, I can still shoot. Is there an enemy? Okay, ready for gamepad? Is there an enemy? Nope, I guess I'll go back to shooting now. That's, you know what that is? That's called science, motherfucker.
And chat, Uncharted is not a shooter. Uncharted is a fucking shitty Indiana Jones knockoff. Which also has a lot of crappy platforming and a lot of crappy people talking.
Yeah.
About it being a lousy Indiana Jones knockoff. Oh, and you have to use a gamepad because it's on the PlayStation 4. Uncharted can fuck right off. That's a shooter.
Right off. Right off.
Technically, at times, you can shoot at things. Yes, that's true.
It's as much as a shooter as it is a platformer. Get the fuck out of here. Shut the front door. How about that? Ooh, what?
Rich, all games with stories are bad for no reasons, Evans. Even though I've only panned it when the story has taken precedence over the gameplay.
I've
praised games that have decent stories when they don't ignore gameplay, like the Batman Arkham games.
This is something that
I don't get.
Rich,
people.
Rich and I are two different people. Jack is the one that doesn't necessarily like stories in games, even though I'm the one that will defend fucking Firewatch, which is nothing but story. And it might just be that you sometimes, like, it depends on the motherfucking game. Hold on, I gotta see if I can read this fucking game. It is just bothering the shit out of me. Oh no, I gotta quit. Alright, well, fuck, man, I guess we just gotta deal with it. Jack is the one who usually doesn't like story in games, but...
Your favorite games, FTL and Doom, don't have any story, Rich. What about XCOM? What about XCOM?
And you know, I think FTL is the king of emergent storytelling.
Mm-hmm.
Every run of FTL, you know, obviously, like, it has a simple framework of get the MacGuffin to point B, right? But the little stories that you concoct to yourself as you go, you're running out of missiles, but you have a missile weapon and you have to fight an enemy, and you know that that is terrifying. Like, an enemy ship comes up and you have three missiles. Do I use my lasers and eke my way through this battle, or do I use a missile and get it over with quickly? Oh, what is my crew going to do? The little bits of emergent storytelling in FTL are more impactful than any bullshit cutscene in Uncharted. So fuck you and your bullshit. Being the Doom Slayer is awesome.
Also, I love FTL. I don't know that it makes my favorite game ever.
You just like
it's great. It's, well, yeah, it's up there, but... quite fond of the Grand Theft Auto games.
Yeah, you've talked about that a lot. About your love of the Grand Theft Auto, of San Andreas specifically.
Well, San Andreas, I like 3, the original. It's been far surpassed by, you know, some of the later ones, but sure, you know, sure. Vice City was great at the time. Eh. 5? I love 5.
Oh, yeah?
4 was dull.
Oh, yeah. 4, I confused 4 and 5. 4 was the New York one, right?
Yeah. Where your friends constantly call you on the cell phone and want to hang out and bore you.
Let's go bowling!
Oh, Red Dead Redemption? Fuck yeah. You need to play that.
Red Dead Redemption?
Oh, yeah.
That's on PC now, right?
No.
What is Call of Juarez?
I've heard for some reason it would be a hard one to port.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
but it's great.
Red Dead Redemption. What is that out on?
Just all of last generation's consoles.
Ah, okay. I don't have any of last generation's consoles.
Well, except for the Wii. That doesn't really...
Hold on. Come. Wait, hold on. Let me be surprised for a moment.
Yeah. Pandru says, hey guys, what are your favorite podcasts? By the way, I saw a Collider video responding to the Nerd Crew in which they referred to Mike's Phantom Menace breakdown / reaction video. SMH.
Shaking my head. Or, as I like to put it, smuh.
Yeah, I got nothing personal against Collider. I don't give a shit what they do. They can do what they want. It's fine. It's all fine.
Everything's fine.
Any favorite podcast? There's a lot of podcasts. I wish I knew which ones were good. I know I've been listening to one that I've kind of enjoyed. I haven't listened to it much lately, but I've been thinking about it. Pirate History Podcast.
Oh, yeah, you're talking about
that.
That
was some good stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fun. I wish...
I've tried to listen to a lot of podcasts, and I'm like, eh, this is blah.
Yeah.
And it's hard for me to find good ones, I would say.
Sure. I consistently wish that more of my day-to-day work didn't involve me having to listen to people talk, so I could listen to more podcasts. Like, back when I had a normal job and I wasn't editing all day, I would listen to podcasts all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the WTF podcast with Mark Maron, or Nerdist podcast, just like listening to like actors and comedians tell stories. I loved it. I loved it, and I would listen to them all the time.
Provided they're good storytellers.
Oh, well, but, like, usually with Marc Maron. Like, Mark's fun. Marc Maron's good. And, or he was. I haven't listened to him in years.
Well, Kevin Smith had a really good Mark Hamill interview.
Oh, I believe it. I believe it.
I think that was the fat man on Batman.
One of his 27 podcasts. But now I can't. I can't listen to podcasts because I'm listening to you and me talk all day. Whenever I'm working. Oh, shit. Shit.
You'll be fine. You're alive. What do you want?
I did.
You lost like a blip.
Well, I did, but every blip is important in these games.
I know it is, but it could have been a lot worse, Jack. Could have been a lot worse.
I mean, that's true.
I'm getting motion sick, and I will not look at the screen.
Stop looking at the screen. We've already been through this.
Ragged Kyrosis, sup, gents?
Sup.
Any updates on Neo?
Neo.
I just got beat the giant centipede on my first try. I'm enjoying it a lot and finding it easier than Bloodborne. We have a review out before the Switch.
Yes. Yeah, I'm about halfway done with our Neo review. There's some things I want to talk about with that, but I can't talk about it yet because I want it to be a surprise for you.
Like, our thoughts you want to be a surprise?
Our thoughts I want to be our surprise. And so, like, there's a lot of Neo that I want to talk about, but you will hear a nice edited version of that soon-ish.
There's one thing I worry about with that upcoming review.
Yeah.
That we're going to come off sounding too negative. Because we bring up a lot of negative points, but that's almost inevitable because we're comparing it to the games it's aping that just do it much better.
And that's really what it breaks down to. But...
And even though in the end I thought, yeah, you know, it's not that bad. You know, it's all right. It's okay. I'm sure watching the review is going to come off like
very negative. Yeah.
Very, very negative.
Yeah. I will say so far it is. Yes. But there's nothing you can really do about that.
But at the end of the day, my response to it is just like, eh.
Pretty much.
Eh.
Pretty much. I think... I've even said this on stream, I think, before, is, like, my official 30-second review of Neo is good enough.
Right.
And that's what it is. Like, it's fine, nothing more, nothing less. But, like, anyone who's coming from Dark Soul or Bloodborne, listen to, who was that? Renegade Akira?
Yes.
Renegade Akira made, like, one of the greatest points ever, which Rich and I made during our review, which is you get through some bosses on your first try. Think about that from a Bloodborne Dark Souls perspective. Is that something you want?
I mostly walked away from, like, a play session of Neo thinking, yeah. I feel like playing Bloodborne.
Yeah. Yeah. I actually started a new game of Bloodborne.
Because of Neo?
Yeah, because of Neo. I'm playing as Hobo Joe, and I want to, Hobo Joe has an axe. I made it like a scrawny man with a giant beard and an axe, and he doesn't get to wear clothes.
All right!
And so he just walks around in his underwear hitting things with an axe. And it's been, Bloodborne. Oh, Bloodborne, I love you.
Lost in Technicolor says, hey guys, I'm playing a nice little game on PS4 now called Unravel. It's a little puzzle / platformer in which you play as a little guy made of yarn trying to retrieve an old lady's memories. Hmm. I've never even heard of it. I'm sorry, I cannot comment further.
I've seen it. I've seen it around the store. I don't know anything about it. But I've seen it around the store. Why am I stuck?
Please remind Jack there are other games to play that aren't as ugly and dingy looking and repetitive as this.
Oh, I'm enjoying this. You know what? By the way, yes, this looks very ugly. I can be with you.
The plan was to play several things.
Yes. Well, how long have we been streaming? What's
uptime? It's 7:45.
Uptime. Hey, someone has to ask Hackbot. Exclamation point uptime. How long have we been streaming?
I don't know if this counts the 52 minutes, 29 seconds.
Okay, well, so we haven't even been into it for an hour, and we had a little downtime because of, shit. because of the crash.
Tyan Sad says,
yep.
Rumors of Ben Affleck leaving his contract as Batman are increasing.
Yep. Oh, also, did you hear the new director left?
I heard somebody say something about that in the chat earlier. I figured it would come up.
The new director left. They got themselves a studio director, the guy who did both Planet of the Apes movies.
Yeah.
The planet. So he's like made remakes. He's good with the studio, and he still won't direct it.
All right. Can even like the DC fans now get on board with the agreeing that the DC cinematic universe is a train wreck? Is it now officially a train wreck?
It is a huge train wreck.
Matt Reeves has also backed out of directing the Batman after negotiations got heated.
There you go.
Is Warner Brothers working secret? Is working secretly working for Marvel?
That was the joke last stream that we brought up where
yeah.
Where it was Zack Snyder was secretly working for Kevin Feige. And Zack Snyder's driving away all of these talented directors.
Was that during the last stream or during the last Best of the Worst we joked around about that?
Oh, it all kind of blends together.
Yeah, I know, doesn't it?
Oh, you know, actually, yeah, that might have just been us hanging out and talking.
It might have just been hanging out and talking during the Best of the Worst viewing.
Where we discussed that Zack Snyder was secretly working for Kevin Feige. And driving away all these directors and ruining all of DC, and then once the DC cinematic universe is in rubbles,
it's gonna be announced that he's gonna like direct the new
Infinity War,
yeah, and it was gonna be amazing
and it's gonna be beautiful, or like all of a sudden Marvel Studio is going to like produce his passion project, you know, something dumb, right? The long shot movie or whatever it is he wants to make.
Did we talk about that on stream, or was that actually us talking
sometimes
during the recent Best of the Worst shoot?
Sometimes it's hard to tell. Like, You're giving Zack Snyder way too much credit. Well, yeah, that's part of the joke. That's part of the joke.
I'm not sure if we said that at the table or just like at the couch. It could be a thing that wouldn't even make the episode because it's such a non sequitur.
Oh, right. So apparently we did not say it on stream.
Yeah.
Oh, well, then it's shit. And yeah, that was just something that we said because, yeah, we say stuff. Whoa, fuck.
Graph McMilitary says, didn't get a chance to say this Wednesday, but that WWE 2K16 stream was epic.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Among my top five pre-rec streams, Dick Neutral, FTL, Frog Fractions, Clown Stream, and Wednesday was an other classic.
Clown
Glad you enjoyed
clown
it.
Clown Stream? Wow.
We haven't had a good one in a while, I think is what that means, Jack.
You know what? That was a lot of fun.
That's why I am officially done with Jesus Christ, Shut Up.
Really?
Yeah, you wanted to play. Jack briefly mentioned playing Knights of the Old Republic.
Eh, we had it.
Today,
yeah.
And I'm like, no. Why? What does anyone get out of that?
Yeah, you know, hey, Rich, we can do whatever we want. I'm glad we've come full circle with Jesus Christ, Shut Up already, and you don't want to do it anymore, and that's fine. It was your idea, and we...
I prefer, when the stream is over, people saying, that was the best stream! I prefer reading that.
Yeah. Hey, you know what? We tried something, and I think that's all that really matters, don't you think? Just because it doesn't work doesn't mean it ain't no good. Well, that's actually probably what it means, exactly.
The Blue Blaze says, hi, guys! Do you think you'll try Enter the Gungeon again since the latest big update? This game is reminding me of it. Also, are you going to try out Horizon Zero Dawn? It might actually be good.
I want to play Horizon Zero Dawn, yes.
I think the problem is March has too many things coming out at once. It's like, we should probably do Zelda?
Oh, I mean, we have to do Zelda.
Okay.
When does Horizon Zero Dawn come out?
I think they're both early March.
I mean, Zelda's the big one to do. Like, Zelda's the smart business decision. We need to do Zelda. We need to do Zelda.
It's the one I'm legitimately more interested in, but I am worried it won't be good. Like, I am worried it's going to be a giant empty world based on what I've seen.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're doing Zelda.
Okay.
No matter what. Executive decision, Rich.
Sure.
I'm making one.
Well, it's a good thing I'm not arguing with you, because I think I have just as much say.
You do. You do have just as much say. But usually it boils down to whichever one of us is most passionate about something.
I would say, no,
we have to do Zelda. So even if you didn't want to, we would be doing Zelda, is I guess what I'm trying to say. I don't want to, like, diminish your input, but it's going to happen. So the question is, when is the release date?
I think next month we're getting the Switch,
yeah,
which would include Zelda.
Yeah.
We're getting Zero Dawn.
Okay.
Nier Automata.
Is that March 2?
I think it's March. That's March 2.
Fucking hell.
And Mass Effect Andromeda, which don't even count on. Like I said, I'm going to shred any copies that get sent to me.
Right.
Please don't send me a copy. Just give the money to charity.
Yes.
If you give me a digital, it's going to be a complete fucking waste, because I can't even destroy that on camera.
Right. We're going to put it on a flash drive and destroy it.
Right. Like, that would work.
Listen, I'm just trying to think of the videos to make out of it, right?
The series is dead to me.
So, someone tell us when the release date for Horizon Zero Dawn is. Please. Chat.
Somebody's saying 3/3/16, but I don't know if that's Zero Dawn or Zelda, because I know that's when Zelda's coming out.
That's Zelda.
I doubt they're both coming out the same day. They might, but that'd be dumb on Zero Dawn's part.
Well, no, or else that's smart on Zero Dawn's part, because if you have a PlayStation 4 and you don't have a Switch, you want the nice thing to talk about, right? You want the new toy to talk about. Do they both come out on the 3rd? Because that would suck for us, video-wise.
Oh, for fuck's sake, I gotta explain this every time. Or do I?
You get to choose what you say, Rich.
All right. Then Mass Effect 3 turned the Mass Effect universe into a dumpster, and I'm not interested in the universe anymore,
right.
So I'm not interested in the new game that takes place in the universe.
There you go.
I'm just not interested.
No, that's a simple one. Well, and you know what? You'll have to get used to an easy way to say that, because for the videos we make of you destroying them, well, I will need you to recap that at the beginning of every video.
No, I'm just going to quietly do it.
No.
We don't need to say anything. I'm just going to throw it in whatever death contraption we have. I'm just gonna hear.
No, I have a nice list going of ways that we can.
Please give the money to charity instead. Give it to kids with cancer.
Yep.
They need it. Bioware doesn't need it. They're already dead.
Ah. What?
Zero Dawn is February 28th.
What?
That's somebody in the chat just said.
Oh, shit. That's...
that's super right around the same time.
Can we do that?
I don't know that we can. We can try.
Can we do that? And how many days are there in February?
We can do a double episode.
Well, no, we'll just film two and make it two videos.
Sure.
Oh, shit. There are only 28 days in February, too. So 3 days late, we'd have 3 days to play it. If that's true. Can someone confirm? 4 days apart. Sorn of a Borch.
What if it turns out Mass Effect Andromeda is really good? Unlikely. Plus, my character in Mass Effect is dead. I'm really not invested in some new schmuck. I don't care. Go away. I want to have fun. I'm sick of talking about crap I don't like. I'm sick of it. All right. Where we got here? Tyron Sad says, without getting too specific for obvious reasons, Have you guys ever lost interest in an artist because of their political views, such as Mel Gibson, Susan Sarandon, etc.? I don't know about political views. I know...
JonTron's like, been an asshole lately.
What?
Oh, a guy who used to make video game videos.
What did he do?
He's just being an asshole lately, so like...
I'm an asshole, so... What is that?
What is this?
That's like Tom Cruise is like creepy enough that I have trouble watching him.
Oh, yeah?
I have no comment on JonTron because this is all fucking completely new to me.
Oh, he's...
There's nothing wrong with having a political opinion.
No, oh, no. There's nothing wrong with having a political opinion. The question is, like you said...
Adults can deal with people having different opinions.
Of course they can. But like you said with Tom Cruise, right? Like, Tom Cruise is just weird enough where it's like, you don't even want to watch him. And so, like, if someone's political opinion or opinion on other things in life, not even political, like, what if, like, that NBA star who's a flat earther,
mm-hmm.
right? Like, you just, like, if you're a fan of that
team, you just think he's a dumbass.
Right. But wouldn't that taint you watching?
No, you just think he's a dumbass.
Right. But so, like...
There was a member of the 2005 White Sox team who thought, what was it, something crazy about dinosaurs, that, like, dinosaur bones were put there by the devil. It was, like, really,
right.
Some really dumb young Earth creationist stuff.
Uh-huh.
I didn't care. He hit the run! Yay!
You know what? Yeah, there's some things that, like, if someone says enough dumb stuff where it's like, I just don't want to watch you anymore. And I think that's normal. I get to choose what I watch with my time. I want to spend it on things I like.
All right, I choose not to talk about politics. So
great.
Laura Argon says, "Did Rich receive the gift from Steam?"
Yes.
Which one?
No.
Probably did. Which one?
Maybe.
I don't know what it was.
I don't know.
So I can't say.
Yeah, you're asking me. I don't know what it was.
If it was sent to the pre-rec Steam account, I don't know what... I haven't checked that in a while, so I don't know what's on there.
Yeah.
Last gift I got, somebody gave me WWE 2K17. Yeah. So the newer one. And they don't have presets in the character creation.
What? I wasn't paying attention. I'm sorry, I was reading the chat.
The last gift I got was somebody sent me WWE 2K17. So that the current year.
Yeah.
They ruined the character creator.
What do you mean?
You know, they don't have presets. Like, who wants to start completely from fucking scratch?
Oh,
from just the base model? Yeah, that's how you end up with mutants. You have... The smart way to do it is you have a ton of presets that look decent, then you pick one of those that's close to what you want, and then you tweak it.
Right.
The skin may be a little bit darker, hair, let's make that blonde,
yeah.
A little rounder here in the cheekbones. But you want that preset to get you partway there.
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah.
You don't want to start from scratch with the base face.
I wonder if coming from their fan base was like, no one uses the presets. Get out of town with the presets.
The Blue Blaze says, speaking of storytelling in games.
Storytelling in games.
Are there any that have good gameplay, but you find the setting and lore behind it one of its best aspects? Gungeon is that for me. And why I play it more than Isaac.
Interesting. I honestly just don't care about the lore in Gungeon at all. You know, like even Isaac, like, you know, I guess, and just from the way that I grew up, I'm more inclined to empathize with Isaac, where I grew up in a very religious household, and so like that speaks to me. But Gungeon, I don't quite get that.
I would say Thief. Thief was a game that
that's just what you always say for everything.
Because it's a great fucking game. Thief, when it came out, innovative gameplay, stealth, and it did stealth good. Mm-hmm. You know, and the world is just kind of beautiful and atmospheric. It was like they did both things perfectly. Good gameplay and a just a great world.
Mm.
So my answer to that is Thief. Just Alex 64 says, in the Starship Troopers review, Mike apologized for bringing up Star Trek yet again. Do people actually give you shit for that? I thought the consensus was that fans want you guys to talk about Star Trek more. Unless they want us to talk about Star Wars more. I don't know. I have no care about talking about Trek. I'll talk about Trek all day. It's fine to me. I don't care. It might have just been apologizing to Jay.
More likely.
Right. Dominic Mousetrap says, hey guys, huge DC fan as always. Watching the DC Cinematic Universe unfold is almost like watching a friend turn into a heroin addict.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Here's the thing. When your friend dies of his heroin addiction, he can't start again from scratch.
Are you saying the DC Universe is worse?
They've got a leg up. They've got a leg up on the heroin addict.
What this is it's your friend coming clean, right? That's when they stop making movies, but when they reboot it again, it's relapse. It's horrible. I love it.
Oh, God, why did all this stuff of reading crash? There we go. There it all is. It's all back. Everything's back. Everything I was looking at is back. Godlygook says, if you're not doing any Jesus Christ shut-ups already, does that mean you do or don't want us to keep pestering you to play games you won't? Because I have a great one to suggest. Yep, Final Fantasy. Moving right along. Old Handsaw says, help! I brought a pack of turkey and cheddar Lunchables Thursday night. I just found them in a grocery bag today. I did not refrigerate. Would you still eat them? Maybe just the crackers? Hashtag hungry. Your crackers are fine. You might want to be careful about the other things. I think...
Lunchables?
Yeah.
Yeah,
cheese is usually a bit more shelf-stable than it's given credit for. You know,
I mean, it's processed cheese, so you'll probably be all right. Even the meat...
The meat, no. No, I wouldn't risk the meat.
I mean,
meat goes bad quick. Meat goes bad quick.
Oh, yeah, but it's like Lunchables. It's not even meat.
I wouldn't buy the Lunchables in the first place, but...
Right, no, throw everything out.
Your crackers are fine.
Everything goes in the garbage. Everything.
If it comes with a little candy bar, you know, that's fine.
Everything goes in the garbage.
Ooh.
Okay, I have died.
Rich has thought long about this. I used to work at a grocery store. I had to throw out old Lunchables.
Yeah.
Amongst other things, but I made... You know, the box would go in the bag, but, you know, I might hold on to the candy bar in there. It's being thrown out anyway. You know. What are my thoughts about the discovery of gravitational waves that happened earlier in 2016?
Yeah, that was neat.
I don't remember hearing about that. I think I missed that particular discovery.
Gravitational waves have been a long theory.
Yeah.
But they developed a device that showed them to be true.
Mm-hmm.
And you know,
that's usually what happens when you discover proof of something.
Well, they said they discovered gravitational waves, but like they kind of knew gravitational waves were there, but so you know, like it was a very long laser.
You need a way to actually measure them. Right. Yeah, yeah.
It's very exciting stuff. They did a bit explaining how we could see them with the laser, and you know, like. Yeah, because the laser gets warped, and you know, like, hey, here, you know, as an example, you know, here's a laser, and I want you to like sing at the laser, and he sang at the laser, and you know, like we saw the sound waves,
yeah.
And so it's like, so that's how we can see, you know, see sound waves, and it's kind of similar with gravitational waves, and it's like, because they had these two very precisely calibrated mirrors, and the mirrors would you know fluctuate with the gravitational wave, and it's, ooh, yeah, it's neat.
The more true things we learn about the universe, the better.
Yeah, it's great.
I'm for it.
Yep. Yeah, it's great.
Yonder Yonder says, I apologize for being an hour late, but I was watching movies at Justin's house. You understand.
Yeah.
Can you please go ahead and start over so I won't have missed anything? Thanks. Very considerate.
I don't think you missed much.
Yeah, not really.
I didn't really talk about much.
You missed a nasty crash.
Yeah, that's about it. That's about it for now. So you're fine. You're fine. What else was I going to play? Oh, I remember. I think. What was it called? Yeah. Okay. I remember. I remember both things and stuff, Rich. That's a thing about me. Whoa. Let's update the stream real quick with the new game we're going to play. Because we're going to play a new game. Rich, you want to play a game? You want to play this other game?
That's fine. What game is this?
Ninja Pizza Girl.
Okay, it seems like a you game, but